There once was a girl who could not reach the stars. She wished that one would come down to her instead. Her wish came true, and one day a star fell to her. She was enveloped by it. It granted her every wish. She became a princess. The world grew for her. Yet this left her feeling empty. Casting away the star, her towers crumpled and her trees withered. And she began the long ascent to the sky. Throne. Hello everyone, Golden Tales Geek here. Welcome to Playing Video Games for the First Time, my series of first impressions videos, and more importantly, welcome to the first one of 2019! Happy New Year, everybody! I'm glad you guys are still sticking with me. If you're new to my channel, well, every Saturday I put up first impressions videos of, almost every Saturday, videos of games that I've never played before, or usually if it's a remake of a game that I have played before but I've never played the remake, I'll do first impressions of that as well, because, you know, playing a video game for the first time doesn't necessarily mean it's my first time playing a remake. Yeah, I know, exact words. I like to abuse that whenever I can. Anyway, this is the Amber Throne, a kind of RPG Maker type game you can get on Steam. I bought it a few years ago during a sale, but I haven't gotten a chance to really try it. It's kind of a, like I said, an RPG Maker game. Like, so it's an RPG of sorts. I don't know. It's made by this guy named Joshua Missile, I believe is his name. And he also did this one game called Eldritch Hunter, which was, I've played a little bit of it and is pretty good. So, although that's his second game, this is his first game. I haven't really had a chance to play this one yet. I've been putting it off for way too long, it seems. But yeah, I'm gonna give this game a shot, so let's start it. A star fell from the sky with the power to grant our every wish. All of us rushed to claim it. It says press X to skip, but I'm not gonna skip it. Only I succeeded. Music sounds downright sinister, not gonna lie. Whoa! That caught me off guard. These words will be my last. Perhaps when you awaken, you will understand. Why stars must stay out of reach? Pretty impressive animation. For me, anyway. I cannot stop them. I tried to take it again, but you must not let them. Blimp or something. Or Zeppelin or something. Still kind of cool, though. A new awakening. Okay. I guess we have to head over this way then. Return to the sky and destroy the Amber Throne. Well, hence the title, it seems. An entry in your journal. Ah, here we go, a menu. Ara, she seems to be, he or she seems to be our main character. Oh, it keeps track of how many steps you've taken. And let's see. Let's check the journal, then. Awakening. The world appears different from when I'd left it. The mountains and plains that taunted my imagination as a child seem to have withered into deserts as an adult. Father's castle looms over the world abandoned, appearing both as a clue and an answer. Destroy the Amber Throne were his last words. Though ships ascend to his shrouded castle, it seems my awakening is poorly timed. I can't help but wonder if this was out of pride in his legacy, or something more. Mysterious. That's a lot of HP early on in the game, though. I guess the enemies must be pretty brutal. Alright, let's check. Okay, we don't have any items, or weapons, or armor, or whatever. Okay, we're in the Red Desert, so, yeah. Let's check our skills here. Level 4, though, that's kind of cool. Oh, we got skill points we can use to learn things, and we can equip skills and such. That's kind of neat. Ooh, I like some of the names of these skills. Skybreaker, Moonbreaker, Sunbreaker, Starbreaker, Crescent, Horizon, Prism, Serpent's Tongue, Leviathan's Tongue, Chimera's Tongue, Dragon's Tongue. These are actually really cool. Alright. Is there anything I can... I guess the only thing we have equipped now is an ancient sword, which shouldn't be too bad, I guess. And of course, we probably have a lot of party members who are going to be joining us in this game. I mean, it is an RPG. Check the map here. That's a neat looking map. Oh, okay, you know what? I'm going to save my game here. Go, save, and let's see system here. Okay, you know what? I am going to do an auto dash here, just to make things easier on movement. Because, there we go, that's better. I just find auto dashing a lot easier in certain RPGs nowadays. It's for me. Received a potion. Cool. Potions, I assume, like in most RPGs, would be the healing items of the game. So, stands to reason, I guess. A lot of deserts up here. It's a mess. None of the king's ships have made it through the cloud yet, have they? We'll get there soon. We're far enough ahead of the Sair as it is. Hey, who's that? Another foreigner. Ah! Okay, I did not mean to do status. Skill. Let's try the skill up. Deals 80% blunt damage to opponent and removes defense buffs. Okay, let's give that a shot. Ouch. Well, at least it's a good thing I have so much HP at the outset, otherwise I'd probably be in deep shit. There we go, good riddance. Woo! Red cape, huh? I might have to equip that. Why you? No foreigner's taking me down! Famous last words, bro. You're an awfully weird-looking hermit. Okay, skybreaker. Let's do that again. Shunk. This guy again. There we go, good riddance. I leveled up! Yay! Found a lot of gold, earned a lot of experience. Awesome. Good riddance to bad rubbish. Ooh, I can open the skill menu though. Okay, let's learn some new skills then. Oh, I got 50 skill points now. Alright, let's learn Crescent here. Deals melee damage to multiple foes, must charge. Okay, that's fair. Alright, and... oh, we got more skills here than I noticed. Okay, cool. But yeah, okay, we've got all kinds of cool moves we can learn here. Okay, sweet. Equip. Oh, I already have Crescent equipped. Okay, sweet. And speaking of equipping, let's equip that red cape I got. Let's optimize our equipment. There. Increases evasion by 1%. Okay. But yeah, I just wanted to make sure I equipped that red cape that we got from that first hermit. Alright, let's just head over this way. Another potion. Nice. In fact, how much HP did this the thing open restore? 900 HP for one ally. Yeah, I think I'll keep that in mind. Something tells me I'm going to be facing some tough enemies. So I think I'm going to keep that for now. Hello. What's this? Some copper gauntlets and different chests for equipment. Okay, that's cool. Then again, I've seen that in a lot of RPGMaker games, so it's not a big deal, really. Increases defense by 5 and attack by 1. Okay, cool. We got a little more attack power, and we've got a little more defense, so that should prove pretty invaluable. Alright, let's head on our way continue onwards, then. Yeesh, a lot of corpses around. Strung around. Is there any way? Fallen warrior, appearing reptilian. Yeah, why not? Let's fight these guys. Because I could use the experience. Ah! Are you serious? Ow. I'm dead. Great. Alright. Okay, I guess I'm not fighting them. I think I'm gonna save that game. Nope, I can't save on the audio save slot. Okay, fair enough. But still, you know, thank you for... yeah. Automatically saving my game, I guess. I guess I'll just avoid those people for now. Hello, who are these guys? What's a Westerner doing around here? Saw ships heading toward the Sky Castle, I'll bet. Go die in the desert with the rest of the lizards and foreigners. No one enters or leaves this city without the king or sage's orders. Jeez, what jerks. You got a death wish, kid? Beat it. Okay. Calm yourself. Neat-looking graffiti. Received a hardened ring. Wonder what that does. Probably another defense-boosting item. Let's see what it does here. Okay. Here we are. Oh, yep. Another defense. Defense 40. There we go. That should help. I'm assuming other means accessory in this particular context. So let's save my game again. I'm a bit of a saving nut sometimes when it comes to these RPGs, you know, because you never know when you're gonna get killed. Alright, I'm just gonna saunter back over here and, yeah, I'm gonna wander around some more. Save my game again just because I want to fight this. Whoa. Why are you wandering away so far away there? Let's try fighting these assholes. Item. Let's use a potion. I'm dead again. Damn it. Alright, let's open the auto. We're just gonna load up my save file here on the regular thing. Alright. You know what? I'm just gonna heal up my potion thing and see if I can defeat these assholes again. Item. Use potion. There we go. Oh, I recognize that noise from a lot of RPG Maker games I've played. Alright, let's save again. There we go. Alright, assholes. Come on. Seriously? Alright. Never mind. I'll come back for you guys later. See what else I can do then. Maybe if I can, maybe I'll explore a bit more than around the desert area. Maybe there's more equipment I could use to kind of up my defenses against some of these assholes. Excuse my language, by the way. I try not to curse too much, but lately it's just been a little. It's been happening a lot. Yes, I can. There's no other way I can go except forward. Oh well. Things are really getting good, too. Alright, can I head around this way, maybe? Oh, no, I guess not. Yeah, I'm beating it. I'm beating it. That sounded less suggestive in my head. Okay, let's wander around here, see if I can find anywhere else I can go. That ring is the only way I can really go, and unless I beat the snot out of those assholes. Hello. Aha! Here we go! Secret passage! Of sorts. Yeah, I know. I've been watching a lot of H.C. Bailey lately. Particularly his Radiant Historia Perfect Chronology Let's Play. Really good game. I have it to myself. Got another potion. Awesome. Cool. I even emulated some of his stuff. A bucket of chalk. Okay, that explains the green. You're too? The king's surrounding the big castle in the sky so he can take the Amber Throne. We don't trust him or those white-robed ones, though. This wall is how we all get out of this. I won't say a thing, but the guards will notice you. The king's ordered all foreigners to be slain. Charming. Kids here aren't afraid of foreigners. The king sure is, though. Yeah, well, I'm Cheryl. I can make you special powders or local plants if you'd like. I'm all over, so if you need anything, come talk to me. Well, thank you, Cheryl. I'll keep that in mind. But still, king doesn't like foreigners. Huh. Reminds me of a... Well, never mind. I don't want to get too political. But whatever. One day, Princess Evelyn will save all of us. We've got to show everyone else. Princess Evelyn is smart, strong, and beautiful. Unlike that big, dumb king and his seedy sages. Nice. It's calm above the city. Red soldiers never look this high. We're safe up here. Even the thieves hiding on the wall don't come. We've got nothing of value to do. Anyway. Is there anything I could... Can I check this box? No, guess not. This isn't Golden Sun where you can check all sorts of things for items, I guess. Ah, that's why I was hearing a flute. I'm really impressed with the music in this game. I'm gonna have to definitely get some, get the soundtrack. Who are you? Another foreigner. You don't look like you're struggling. What brings you here? The Emperor Throne? You don't seem to have an army. You're either naive or mad. Perhaps we can help each other then. I've got things to need taken care of. The ship's heading for it. Coming, asshole. If you want, I can help you get there. You're on your own after that. Stranger joined the party. Well, okay. Where are you two going? That cloaked girl is strange, but she helps us learn about the world. I think I can guess who she is. I'm not going to make any guesses offhand, though, because I don't want to... I really don't want to feel like I'm... I don't want to feel like things are predictable, but still. Alright, what have we got here? Honey wheat bread. That must be another healing consumable. Let's check what that does here. Yeah, okay. Restores 500 HP experience gained by 10% for 10 turns. That's actually kind of neat. I'll have to keep that in mind. So plus, I've had honey wheat bread in real life. It's delicious. Then again, I love wheat bread in any capacity, really. Especially if it's got little seeds and stuff in it, or if it's got oatmeal or something. I don't know. I'm rambling about food. This fortress was built not by us, but an ancient empire of man. They forged blades to strike down corrupt amber gods and their machinations. All the blades were lost but one. They were wisely contained by Axis within his old kingdom, lest thwarting him would have been easier for the rebels. Though not contained enough, it seems. I've always admired him, I suppose. The people believe the king and his sages are ignorant. Poor rulers and a poorer fit to claim the Amber Throne. There are good rulers in this world, however. A wise one can change everything, just as Axis attempted. You know, it's funny that the princess's name is Evelyn, because I actually have a friend who has a young daughter named Evelyn who's absolutely adorable. And I actually met said little girl too recently. So, and she's just so cute. And they also call her Evie for short, which is kind of cute. So, alright. Two potions. Cool. Okay. Whoa! First time a fool stopped by in a long time. Oh lordy, here we go. Okay. Well, stranger doesn't have any skills, so let's just attack the thief then. Alright. Go. Oh, Seriously. So I guess there's a little strategy element to these RPGs, to this game. That's nice. Yes, let's continue. Copper armor. Okay, let's see if we can equip that on somebody. What does the copper armor do? It must defense by 9 and attack by 2. Okay, nice. Thank you for that. Still, that thief was pretty nasty looking. Wouldn't want to run into him in a dark alley, that's for sure. Let's drop over here. Oh, we got another thief. Okay. You're a real brave coming down here. Yeah, I'll bet. Good riddance. And the stranger leveled up. Gold is certainly plentiful in this game, I will say that much. A thieves dagger. Would that be something that you can equip? Let's see. Nope, it's something the stranger can equip. Okay. Think. Oh, I did not mean to do it. And what? Equip stranger. There we go. Okay, I guess it's not something the stranger can equip either. Let's check the item slot here. Oh, it's an armor! Okay. Increases equip. Is it an accessory? You know what? I think I'll equip it on her. Why not? There we go. Okay, it's an accessory. Cool. Alright, I'm gonna save my game again, just be on the safe side here. Because you never know. Never know what kind of problems you might run into. Still, at least we're getting some good equipment. Though I've never really heard of a dagger being an accessory before. It's kind of weird. Should have sensed something was up when I didn't see it listed amongst the regular equipment, but yeah, whatever. These RPG Maker games can be kind of tricky to figure out sometimes. At least I think so. I didn't used to really like RPG Maker games, honestly, but now I've kind of just grown on. They've kind of grown on me. Yeah, let's saunter down here then. The Red City, actually, you know what? Since we've now gotten to the Red City, I'm gonna save my game and call it for today. But, I'm pretty intrigued so far. It's definitely got a good mythology to it so far, and yeah. So this has been the Amber Throne. I hope you enjoyed it. And I'm looking forward to playing more of this in the future, off-screen, of course. So, yeah. Until my next video, whether it's a Let's Play, a playing video games for the first time video like this, a video game boss fight video, any other thing I decide to put on my channel, keep on gaming, everyone. See you later. Oh, and before I go, I will also put a link in the video description so you can check this game out on Steam for yourself sometime. And, also, Let's hope 2019 brings some really great stuff for us. See you later.